The easiest way to make a WordPress blog SEO-friendly. Believe it or not, WordPress is pretty SEO-friendly out of the box. If you want to make it more SEO-friendly, you just have to use plugins like Yoast SEO or All-in-One. But you already know that. Here's what no one tells you. The main reason most blogs aren't SEO-friendly are for two reasons, and you can't solve these issues through plugins. The first reason is you have too much content on the same topic. See, when you blog over time, you'll have writer's block, or you have forgotten what you've written on before. That can cause you to write on the same topic over and over again accidentally. For example, I may have written a post in the past called The Beginner's Guide to SEO. And then a year later, write a post on how to get started with SEO. And then 6 months later, I may write a post called 7 SEO tips for beginners. Although each of those posts are different, a lot of times Google will see them as roughly the same thing because they're all about SEO for beginners. And that can cause confusion with search engines. And Google won't know which term or which post to more so rank for terms like SEO for beginners. So what you'll want to do is combine the posts that are all around similar keywords and put them into one amazing post. This will increase your overall rankings and confuse search engines less. And the key with this is when you have that issue, go to Google Analytics, see which of the pages is the most popular and combine the other pages into the most popular one. And then do 301 redirects and make sure you adjust the internal links that have gone to the old posts and update them to go to the new posts. The second reason your WordPress blog isn't as search engine friendly is because your content is old and outdated. Did you know that Wikipedia is the 7th most popular site in the world according to SimilarWeb? Do you know how they pull that off? Well, their content is continually updated. People keep updating Wikipedia on a daily basis. Heck, some of their most popular pages are even also updated on a daily basis. And some content pieces, especially when there's new news, get updated multiple times within the hour. It's super effective. With most blogs, people write content, they never update them. We find this out with our agency, NP Digital. When we talk to clients, 98% of our clients that work with us before they even started never update their old content. Now, of course, once they start working with us, we change that and we start updating their old content. You want to do this at least once a year. Ideally more than that. And this is an easy way to start generating more traffic. And you're probably wondering, Neil, what old posts do I update? Do I need to update them by a lot, a little? Well, the easiest way to figure out what posts need updating first is to look at Google Search Console. And you can see what pages have dropped in traffic over time. Those are the ones that need updating first. Now, when you update them, you want to look at what are the other competing web pages and blogs that rank above me for the terms that I have lost rankings for. Google them, look at their pages, and see how you can make yours better. Now, the two above reasons aren't hard to fix. They just take time. But the time aspect is why most blogs aren't SEO friendly. They prefer a quick plugin to fix their problems, but not all plugins can fix everything. Sometimes you just need a little bit of human capital. So put in the time and effort and your blog will be more SEO friendly. Or if you want my team to just do this for you, go check out npdigital.com where we can handle all your SEO needs for you. If you enjoyed this video, like it, share it, subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. I'm here to help.